Hi, I'm Tom, one of the senior developer advocates here at Grafana Labs, and in this quick video, I'm going to be introducing you to Dashboards as Code with Grafana. Dashboards in Grafana are typically composed of a JSON configuration file. This makes up all of the rows, panels, data sources, and queries that make up your actual dashboard. But when you want to manage these at scale, it can become difficult or complex to manage these JSON configuration files or just to modify your dashboards within the Grafana UI. So there's another way to do this, and this is using Dashboards as Code. Our solution to this is the Grafana Foundation SDK. The Grafana Foundation SDK is a set of libraries that allow you to write your dashboards as strongly typed code. You can then check this into a repository such as GitHub, and then provision these directly into your Grafana instance, using something like a GitHub action. In this quick video, I'm going to be showing you how you can use the Grafana Foundation SDK to write your first dashboard as code, and then import it into Grafana directly. Before we take a look at any code, I want to point out that the Grafana Foundation SDK has its own set of documentation, which you can find directly on the GitHub page, or you can find it in the description below. This documentation portal covers all of the languages that the Foundation SDK supports, such as Go, Java, PHP, Python, and TypeScript, as well as a bunch of examples to help you get started. Let's switch over to VS Code and take a look at how we can use the Foundation SDK to generate a simple dashboard. Here you can see I'm using Go, so therefore I'm using the Foundation SDK's Go library. Inside my main func, I'm creating a reference to the data source that I want to use within this dashboard. Your dashboard may have multiple data sources, however in my case, I'm just going to use the test data data source. So I'll set up a reference to that here at the top. Underneath that, I'm going to use the dashboard builder that comes as part of the Foundation SDK to create a new dashboard with a title of My Dashboard. Inside this dashboard, I'm going to have a panel, and you can see here that I'm using a stat panel. I'll use the builder here, which you can find references to within the Foundation SDK documentation, and I'm going to give it a title of version. I'm going to use the test data source that we defined at the top there, and then I'm going to pass in some options here for how we're going to grab the data for this stat panel. And finally, I'll pass in a target function here. This will then use a data query builder on that test data source. And for this, I'm going to use the CSV content scenario, and I'm going to pass in some CSV content here, just static data, just for an example purpose. For all of the functions here, you can find references for them and what they do in the Foundation SDK documentation. Alternatively, you can create a dashboard directly within Grafana and take a look at the JSON configuration for that dashboard. The property names there will map directly to functions within the Foundation SDK. The next thing I'm going to add is a new panel. This time we're going to be a time series panel. We're using the time series panel builder for this. I'm going to give it a title of random time series. Again, we're using that test data reference. And then we're going to pass in the query builder for this test data. And here we're just going to pass the random walk scenario ID in just to give us a random time series graph there. The final thing we're going to do is called the builder's build function. This is then going to output the JSON that we're going to use to import into Grafana. I'm going to serialize this out to a JSON string, and then I'm going to print it out to the console. So what does this look like in practice? So if I come over to the terminal here and I run this, go run main.go, you'll see that we get an outputted JSON payload. This is the dashboard itself. So I'm going to copy this, and I'm going to come over to our Grafana instance here, and I'm going to create a new dashboard. I'm going to press the import dashboard button. I'm going to come down to the JSON input field here and paste in the output from our Foundation SDK code. Then I'm going to press load, give it a name, and press import. And you'll see here now that we have our dashboard that we generated from strongly typed code. We have the stat panel with the content here that we specified in our code, and then we have the random time series graph here. So that was a super quick introduction to the Foundation SDK and how you can use it to write strongly typed code and convert it into dashboard JSON configuration files that Grafana can understand. You can find all of the code for this example in the GitHub repository linked below. In the next video, we'll look at a more complicated example and show you how you can use the Grafana HTTP API to automatically import your dashboards directly into your Grafana instance. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.